Hey there, ServiceNow enthusiast. Welcome back to our channel TechnoMonk, where we simplify ServiceNow concept and make them fun to learn. Today we are diving into a powerful and practical concept, the three-strike approval process in ServiceNow. So if you have ever wanted to create a flexible approval system, okay, that gives user multiple chances to approve a request before escalating or rejecting it, okay, this video is for you. By the end of this video tutorial, you will know exactly how to implement three-strike approval process in ServiceNow step by step. So let's get started. So all right, let's start with the basic. What is three-strike approval process? We can say that it's a workflow where an approver gets three chances to approve or reject a request. If they don't respond within a set frame of time, the system automatically either escalates the request to the next approver or take a predefined action like rejecting the request. This is super useful for ensuring that approvers don't get stuck and that your workflow keeps moving smoothly. Think of it as a polite but firm nudge to keep things on track. In order to understand it in an easier format, okay, let's look at a real-world example. Imagine you are managing an IT service desk and someone submits a request for a new laptop. The request goes to the manager for approval. If the manager doesn't respond within 24 hours, or it may be the time frame may be anything based on your organization. So if the manager doesn't respond within 24 hours, the system sends a reminder. If there is still no response after 48 hours, the system sends a second reminder. And finally, if there is no response after 72 hours also, the system escalates the request to the department head or it automatically rejects it. So what this process does, this process ensures that request doesn't fall through the crack and that your team can stay productive. Now let's see how we can build this in ServiceNow. So I've already built the solution for it. I will explain how you can define it. So first and foremost thing, as we discussed, we want to send the reminder notifications, right? So we start with the notification. Before that, I've created an event registry. Okay, I've created an event called three-strike approval. So for this particular demo, I've created one event and one notification only, which is generic across all the reminders. Okay, but in real case kind of thing, you can create different events and different notification. Okay, for first, second, and third reminder notification. But in this case, I've created one only. So there is a three-strike approval notification event. Pretty simple. The table list is approval, and it's fired by workflow. Okay, that's it. Nothing. That's the name. Now this particular event, whenever it gets fired, it triggers a notification. Which notification? So I've created a notification. I have not defined any body in that particular notification because I'm yet to get that particular information from my client. So it's event-based notification. When event is fired, then this particular notification is sent. It's the same event. And who will receive? I've just mentioned the param1 user. And I've just added approval reminder in the body also. It's approval reminder only, nothing. But you can change it as per your preferences, okay? After that, what I did, I've created a few properties out there, okay? And I'll be explaining these properties as we go forward in this particular tutorial. So as you can see, I've created three-strike approval reminder first, second, third, okay? So I don't want to make anything hard-coded on the workflow side. So basically what this particular property is doing, I will explain you that. So first and the foremost thing is the time frame one, this particular property. So basically it's a time frame, okay? I'm using it as a second, so it's 60 seconds. So if I want to count 1 minute, okay? If I want to put a timer of 1 minute, so I will be multiplying this with the number of minutes I want to do that. So I'm just counting it minute, that's why it's 60. The grace period is like how I design the flow is first notification will go after a certain amount of time, then second notification will go, then third will go. If a user is still not approving the request or rejecting the request, we'll put a grace period, somewhat grace period, and after that particular grace period, it will get auto rejected because we are giving him chance 4 times, right? And for my application, what I've done, I've just for practical purpose, I've kept everything one. That means as soon as the approval get initiated, the first notification will go within 1 minute. Okay. If it's not approving, it will, the next notification will go again after 1 minute. If it's still not acting on it, the third, again 1 minute, and the grace period is also one. But you can change it out, okay, based on your requirement. Okay, if you want to make it in hours, so you can do 60 multiplied by 60 over here. Okay, if you want to make it day, it will be 60 multiplied by 60 into 24. I think you got the point, okay? So this way you can define everything out. Now, this is done. Now we will move to the workflow, okay? How exactly is defined? If I go to the workflow, this is the workflow I've designed, which is called three strike approval. I will just quickly check out this workflow just to showcase what all things I've developed over here. So basically let's begin. Okay. And this particular workflow, when it gets triggered, let's see the trigger condition. So the trigger condition for this particular workflow is on CIS approval table. And condition is, approve is not empty. Definitely approval should not be empty on that particular record. And state is requested. Okay. So what it does, first and foremost thing, it runs a run script. Okay. What's written in this particular run script? So based on the properties we have defined over there, I'm formulating some scratchpad variables like first reminder. What is the time frame for first reminder? It's first reminder multiplied by time frame. So time frame, we have kept it as 60 seconds, right? So it will be 1 minute. Means it will be 60 seconds. For second reminder, again, it will be 60 seconds because 1 multiplied by 60 is 60. Okay, the third reminder is 60 and grace period is 60. But based on your properties, it will differ. Okay, if you want to make it R, okay, so you can do multiply by 60 also. Okay, one more 60, or you can add it to the system property as 3600. Perfect. So here, and I'm putting those things into a scratch pad. So there is a scratch pad for first reminder, second reminder, third reminder, and grace period also. Perfect. So this is good. Now, what it will do, as soon as the approval gets triggered, okay, the first reminder, there will be a timer for the first reminder. How much is the timer? So over here, I've given answer equal to workflow.scratchpad.firstReminder. That means it will be 60 seconds. Because here we have to pass the answer as second number of seconds, right? It will be 60. So it will wait for 60 seconds if there is no approval. Okay. And I have added the wait for condition also. Okay. In parallel. So either we have to wait for 60 seconds or a person approved it out. Okay. What is there in the wait for condition? This is the condition that the state is not requested. Okay. That means that particular approver doesn't need to approve anything out now or reject anything out. So that's completely fine, right? So either of the case should match. If 1 minute pass on, will trigger an event. What this event? The same event which we have seen over there. So if you see event three strike rule, and I am returning current.getValue of approval. That means the approver CSID. Perfect. It works, right? Then after the first notification got delivered, if it's still not approving or rejecting the things, again it's checking whether the wait for condition is getting satisfied. If not, it will send the second notification. The same thing, okay? Just in timer, I will just change the scratch pad. That's it. Okay, workflow.scratchpad. And if you want to send different notifications on every event, so you can do that also. You have to just create a different event and different notifications. Perfect. But I'm using the same thing. The same event. And still, if it's not getting approved after 2 minutes, the third timer will get triggered. It will again wait for 1 minute. After the third reminder also done, if it's not getting passed, okay, if it's not getting satisfying this particular value, okay, means it's still in the requested state, then we will wait for the grace period, okay, which is again 60 seconds for us. And after grace period, we will check if it's still in requested state. So what I'm doing over here, I'm just verifying what is the state of that particular approver. If it's still requested, if it's yes, then I'm not interested to escalate to this person also, okay? Because he don't want to approve or reject, okay? So I will simply reject the approval. Okay, I'm just setting the state to approval. But in that particular grace period, if he approves or rejects that particular approval, then we'll just go to the end, okay? Perfect, right? Let's see this particular thing in action. I will just, what I will do, I will publish this particular workflow and we will quickly jump over here and I will go to what? Oh, let me see. Let me see underscore request for item. Let's see if we have some item out there where we can test this out. AWS account creation, perfect. Let's look into this particular item and we'll do try it. So I'm just raising a request, IT dev, and I will for testing. I will keep, okay? And I will do order now. Okay, now we have done the order now. We'll open the request. So here we can see request item is there. If you see request item, hopefully there is approval for the perfect. There's approval over here. Okay. Now it's in requested state. Now let's see how the workflow context will work for this. So we'll go and what we'll do, we'll just go to active context. Or we can do like this also. Okay. I'll just go here. I'll do show context. There'll be, okay. Executing just now, perfect, and we will do show workflow on a real time. So the run script happened, okay, and is waiting for 1 minute, okay. So either of it's waiting for either of this condition should. So let's wait for 1 minute. I will just refresh, okay, in case as soon as the 1 minute get crossed, we will see if the notification got triggered or not. So 1 minute over. The notification get triggered and it's again waiting for the second reminder. Again 1 minute. Okay. Till that particular point of time, let's see if the event got triggered. Okay. So we'll go to event logs just to verify if everything is coming through. The event logs, and if I do start 3. Okay. Just now. It got triggered and it has a sysid of the user. So this worked. Okay. Now let's check the emails. Emails. Email logs. Or it's emails only, right? I've marked it in favorite. System log emails. Okay. And here if we see. There should be some event triggered. I do. What is the subject line? Star. Approval. Nope. Okay. What happened? Probably that particular user. What was that user? We'll go to favorites. We'll go to what? History. And over here, we'll go to the request item. Oh, it got rejected also. Perfect. Okay. I think we have crossed that particular time. Let's see the workflow once. No context, this particular thing, the workflow. Over here, it got rejected. Why it's happening like this? But the workflow got executed as a whole, okay? Because if you see, over here, if you open the approval, I have also added the comment. The approval was rejected as the approval was so busy that after 3 reminder also it didn't act. Okay. And let's look at this particular user. What's wrong with this particular user? So I will do user, this particular user. Why notification is not getting sent? So I'll get the notification.
enabled, right? I don't know. Email. Sent.
Strange. I have to look into this. But you got the point, right? Okay. That even got triggers. So that definitely something is blocking over there. Okay. Probably the notification. We can quickly check on the notification side also. Let's do that also. So what I'll do, I will go to notification. And then what? Three strike approval.
We will come to know why the notification didn't get triggered, right? And I will go to preview notification.
Oh, something is wrong with this user. Excluded recipient because user has no usable device. What is this thing? Usable device.
What is that?
Check.
Is this something called device?
Email ID is there. I clicked on where I can. So the something is blocking it out. Okay, let's see what that thing is. It's not device. I have to check on this. What exactly is stopping? What is the unusable device, right? But the notification will get triggered. Okay. So this is all for today's tutorial, okay? And that's we got a wrap on today's tutorial. I hope you found this video helpful and you are excited to implement the three-strike approval process in your own ServiceNow environment. Trust me, this is very helpful. I used to have this particular implemented in all the projects, okay? Because no one wants to bear with open tickets, okay? Which are pending for approval for months and years. And also, we don't want an open approval also, right? So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with your team, and hit that subscribe button for more ServiceNow tips and tricks. Got question or idea for future videos? Drop them in the comment below. I would love to hear from you. Until next time, keep building workflow that works for you. Thank you. Thanks for watching.